let's discuss now with Anna Navarro and Adolfo Franco.
Yep.
So hello to both of you. Anna.
Hi, Don.
Hi. What's your reaction to those comments by the president to Steve Cortez at that rally last night, saying, we love our Hispanics?
Look, I suspect he didn't want to offend Steve Cortez, and I suspect Steve Cortez was not offended. But really, what a stupid thing to say, right? To somehow ask the question about whether you love this country more than you love Hispanics. They are one in the same. And, you know, at a moment when he's supposedly celebrating Hispanic heritage, at a moment when little Hispanic kids are getting bullied in school and told to go back to where they came from, when white supremacists driving hours and hours and, you know, drove hours and hours and hours to hunt down Hispanics, echoing some of the same themes that Trump has been saying, really, he could be more careful. That's why words matter, because it's important to highlight right now that Hispanics are America. It is not a choice. It's not either or. It's not who you love more. Hispanics are America. Well, Latinos are America.
I wonder, Adolfo, you say the president was, you said it was just in jest, right? That jest, it was, it was humor, that he's not politically correct. But then why would he say something like, you know, he looks more like a wasp than he does? What, was that supposed to be a compliment?
Well, we didn't say something that I think would be terrible, and is they all look alike, or things of that kind, which are, you know, clearly racist things. Look, I think for all due respect,
he doesn't look like all the other Hispanics.
Well, I had to tell you, I think people have to, frankly, lighten up a bit. I think everybody knows the president was joking. Steve has said as much. I think I know the president. I think he's absolutely joking. Anna, next week you can join us at the White House. The president is having us over to celebrate Hispanic Week. Sorry, I met Steve a couple of years ago. The president is.
Thanks, Adolfo. I'll pass. I'll go when there's a president that does not call Hispanics criminals and rapists. Thank you, though,
well,
for the invitation.
There are criminals and rapists coming over if we don't have a border under control. That's what the president's message is. The president is a person that I think connects with Hispanics, connects with all Americans, frankly, and is a person that isn't going to be, as Bill Maurer the other day said, Don, and I completely agree with him, the country is choking on political correctness. The country's choking on it.
Well,
Bill Maurer is a comedian. And I'm not going to hold the president of the United States and the I'm not going to hold the president of the United States to the same standard that I hold a late night comic. And I am not going to accept things being said in jest and me shrugging my shoulders and making this acceptable when there are kids that are getting bullied, when there are people that are getting screamed at and fired because they speak Spanish, when there are people that are getting killed and hunted down like dogs because they are Hispanic.
I am not going to accept it.
If you want to laugh at it, if you think that's funny, that's your choice.
I think the president
So we can't just keep this in mind. We can't say that everything is too politically correct. We can't let that be a license for people to be bigoted. Okay, there is a difference. Yes, people are very sensitive in this time, but you can't just say everything. People get away with everything because of that term, political correctness. Now I got to get this in because Steve spoke with
Hispanics.
My friend Chris Cuomo
earlier
this evening. Here's what he had to say about the president and how he speaks. Watch this.
I think a lot of Hispanics look at Donald Trump and they may say, look, I would like him if he phrased things differently. I myself would like it sometimes, believe it or not, Chris, if he phrased things differently. I'm the one who has to come on television at times and explain.
Listen, I have a short time left here, but are you ever offended by what he says and wish that he would speak more eloquently about minorities?
I'm never offended. I've never been offended by President Trump. What I look at are, as Steve said in that interview as well, earlier today, is I'm looking at what the results of his policies have been, what it's been for Hispanic unemployment, for Hispanics in this country, and the things he said in this particular clip you just ran. I love Hispanics. We love our Hispanics. Mm-hmm. With people behind him saying Latinos with Trump. Mm-hmm. I mean, the fact of the matter is the president does joke. That is the president's style. That's not racist. And I think the results of his administration
are what Hispanics will judge. Well, listen, if Adolfo doesn't want to be offended, that's his prerogative. I am offended by a president who separates children from their parents. am offended by a president who calls Central American countries shitholes. I am offended by a president who calls Hispanics invaders. I am offended by a president who calls Mexicans rapists and criminals. And let me remind you that in a large swath of the country, even though you might be Cuban,
you were offended that he was elected.
I'm offended that he was elected. I'm offended that a misogynist, racist, who peddles hostility and division, and who boasted about grabbing a woman's pussy, got elected. Hell yes, I'm offended about that. I think it's cheapening of the presidency, and I think it's a low moment in history.
You can be offended. I think you're in the minority.
I will. I don't need your permission. I'm going to be offended until this gross man is out of this White House. And I'm offended by people who you.